The Geminid meteor shower is the most powerful of the year. However, in 2022, the peak occurs on December 14th at 13 Universal Time on a night when the moon would be 72% full, making it difficult to observe a dark sky. On the nights of December 13th and 14th, you might want to consider observing under the moonlight. You might see 120 Geminid meteors every hour in a moonless, pitch-black sky. The shower will last from November 19th to December 24th overall. In years when there is no moon, the bold, dazzling Geminids give us one of the best showers in the Northern Hemisphere. Lower rates of visibility are also possible from the Southern Hemisphere. The Geminid meteor shower is attributed to the asteroid 3200 Phaethon. This is different from the majority of meteor showers, which comets rather than asteroids cause. What distinguishes an asteroid from a comet? A comet is described as a dirty snowball with a solid nucleus covered by an ice coating that sublimates as the comet approaches the sun. Comets often have a density that is only slightly heavier than that of water. They travel in extended orbits around the sun, first getting close to it and then getting further away from it. When a comet approaches the sun, the head of the comet is seen via a telescope as a hazy patch of light surrounding the nucleus. But because only the nucleus is visible when a comet is spotted far from the sun, most comets look like stars. Asteroids are typically rocks. In contrast to comets, asteroids usually have a more circular orbit. Asteroids appear like stars when viewed through a telescope. These definitions were effective up until a few decades ago, when asteroids were first discovered using larger telescopes, and some of these objects developed tails as they got closer to the sun. The term asteroid had to be changed to comet. This means that a body that was once classed as an asteroid can now be called a comet. Can a comet be categorized as an asteroid instead of the other way around? Indeed, it can. A comet's volatile elements may become trapped beneath the nucleus surface, which might cause it to stop functioning. A dormant comet is what this is. A comet is referred also to as extinct after it has lost all of its volatile components. The asteroid 3200 Phaethon appears to be an example of a comet that is either dormant or extinct. Therefore, 3200 Phaethon is a bizarre asteroid-comet hybrid. This rock comet is not frosty like a comet. However, like comets do, it is known to become brighter as it gets closer to the sun. Additionally, it has a tail, and it also produces the Geminid meteor shower. Scientists are perplexed by 3200 Phaethon as a result. How may a stony asteroid leave behind particles that cause a meteor shower? Where does its tail come from? An innovative theory has been proposed by researchers at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena that may provide an explanation for the comet-like behavior of 3200 Phaethon. The sodium that is bubbling up from the asteroid's surface could contribute to the solution. Comets grow more active and brighter as they warm up due to the vaporization of their frozen surfaces, which also causes more light to be reflected by the comet's venting gases and dust. But if ices aren't vaporizing, what is making Phaethon brighten? Sodium might be to blame. According to the authors, Phaethon's extended 524-day orbit places it close to Mercury's orbit, where the Sun heats the asteroid's surface to roughly 1,390 degrees Fahrenheit. Any water, carbon dioxide, or carbon monoxide ice that may have been present close to the asteroid's surface would have long since cooked off due to its heated orbit. At such temperature, though, sodium might be bubbling out of the asteroid's rock and into space. Small rocky space fragments known as meteoroids break up as they fly through the atmosphere of Earth. However, before they do, the air surrounding the meteoroids heats up to thousands of degrees and produces light due to friction with the atmosphere. This light's color corresponds to the ingredients it contains. For instance, sodium imparts an orange hue. The sodium content of the Geminids is reputedly low. It was believed until to this point that these little rocks lost their sodium after leaving the asteroid. According to scientists, sodium may have actually played a significant part in the Geminid meteoroids being ejected from Phaethon's surface. The sodium in the asteroid heats up and vaporizes as it approaches the sun. This process would have long since depleted the sodium on the surface, yet inside the asteroid, sodium continues to heat up, vaporize, and fizz into space through craters and fissures in Phaethon's outermost crust. These jets would have sufficient force to dislodge the rocky debris from the surface. Therefore, the fizzing sodium might account for the Geminid meteoroid's low sodium content, as well as how the asteroid would eject them and explain how the asteroid brightens in a comet-like fashion. It doesn't take much force to kick debris from the surface or knock rock out of a fissure on asteroids like Phaethon because their gravity is so feeble. This asteroid exhibits a number of interesting characteristics in addition to its comet-like activity. One factor is that Phaethon has an unusual color for an asteroid. Depending on the kind of surface material, asteroids typically range in color from gray to red. Phaethon is blue. There are known blue asteroids, however, they only make up a small portion of all asteroids. Moreover, Phaethon is not only blue. It is among the bluest asteroids, or comets, with a similar color in the solar system. Another peculiar Phaethon trait is this. Asteroid orbits are more circular than comet orbits, which are more elliptical. The unusually elongated orbit of Phaethon is similar to that of several comets. Mars, Earth, Venus, and Mercury are all in its orbital path. Additionally, Phaethon is the named asteroid that is closest to the Sun due to its orbit. Phaethon is only 13 million kilometers from the Sun at its closest point. The distance between Earth and Mercury is less than half that. This object's name, 3200 Phaethon, commemorates its connection to the Sun. Phaethon was the sun god Helios' son in Greek mythology. Among the yearly meteor showers, the Geminids are a perennial favorite. For those who see from a dark sky point around 2 a.m. local time, the Geminids are a dependable shower. However, at the busiest viewing hour this year, a waxing moon will be visible above the horizon. On the nights of December 13th and 14th, one choice is to try viewing under the moonlight. Geminid meteors are frequently bright, swift, and white. The moon's light won't be able to compete with the brightest ones. For this shower, the zenithal hourly rate is 120. But you won't likely see that many. You can frequently see 50 or more meteors per hour on a dark night, towards the height of the shower about 2 a.m., for all time zones. 150 meteors per hour are possible on a night when the Geminids are most active. Because of a final quarter moon on December 16th, the peak of the shower will clash with a waning gibbous moon in 2022. The visibility won't be the best in 2022 because of a bright waning gibbous moon that will rise in the late evening and set in the morning. It's an excellent idea to go meteor watching with a friend. You two can then each look in a separate direction. By using this method, you will be able to observe more meteors than if you were to look alone. Give yourself at least an hour, if not longer, to observe. Your eyes need roughly 20 minutes to become used to the dark. Don't give up if you can't observe at 2 a.m. and are disheartened by the fading gibbous moon in 2022 during the shower's peak. In the early evening, when Gemini is close to the eastern horizon, and in 2022, when there is a bright moon in the sky, you won't see as many Geminid meteors. The greatest time to try to catch an Earthgrazer is in the evening, so you might still take a look.